Ha ha ha! Good evening and welcome to another night of spooky Saturday goings on in Bela Lugosi's shed. Now, if you're wondering why I'm doing all this Vincent Price bullshit, it's because this is the Halloween episode, or the closest to a Halloween episode as we're going to get, because right now it is the 29th of October, and ain't nobody got time for streaming until midnight on a Monday evening. But I will be out doing some trick-or-treating with my daughter. Now, yeah, ooh, I just have a comment. Oh, it's LJ. How are you doing? I just got really excited that someone had already commented in my chat. And as lovely as it was to receive a message from LJ, LJ is also here this evening and he's going to be playing Inside the Backrooms with me. So her being on my Twitch is no surprise. Oh, it's not LJ. It is a spooky ghost. Is it spooky, or are you indeed that extra echelon of terrifying spoopy? But anyway, yeah, so I'm here this evening. We're going to be doing a little bit more Inside the Backrooms, and I'm going to be doing it with my two usual partners in terrifying crime, Grey Area, aka Grim, and LJ Matthews Art, aka LJ, who are both joining me, or will hopefully be joining me.
What's this about not streaming till midnight on Mondays?
Well, yes.
Frequently streaming after midnight on
Mondays. The shed is not open on school nights.
Right. My stream is promising that anyone cruising by that I'll be starting anytime real soon now, in fact, but I'm not going to do that because I want to finish making my tea before we start.
I'll do a Halloween stream.
I am going to do a Halloween stream. Can I plug?
Absolutely. I'm going to be out doing some spooky things with daughter.
Yeah. So, for anybody watching, yes, I am doing a dress up Beat Saber stream tomorrow night. In aid of Crisis. As Crisis, they operate all year round, but a particular time that they need funds and resources is Christmas. And I know this because I volunteered for them at their Christmas shelters some time back and see what could they do firsthand, which is a lot. So yeah, that is a thing that's happening.
An excellent thing to be raising money for. And watching you play Beat Saber in your old goth duds is always entertaining. So yeah, I'd recommend that.
I'm about to plonk a link in your chat, if I may. And if you go and check said link, you will note that there are tiers of donations, and should you reach some of them involve costume changes. The final one being, and you'll remember this, Richard, a hot dog costume.
Excellent.
That did belong to our friend Robin, and has somehow passed into my possession. That is going to be an absolute delight, I promise you.
Excellent.
They are subject to some change because
I'm just trying to currently find where switching my focus to the screen showing the donation page, but it cannot get picked up by OBS.
You need to get a screen. Need to use screen capture, not game capture. Yeah. And honestly, I'd advise not right now.
No. Seems like a massive fan.
Oh, I have forgotten to mute.
But anyway, yes, so we've got stream. Game for Crisis with Grey Area on Twitch, Beat Saber Dress Up Stream.
By saying that with a mouthful of mushrooms.
And yeah, so we've got £50, costume change into Sith Cloak, £100, go up one difficulty level, £150, costume change Mad Doctor, £200, hot dog costume, and £250, we'll get the stream extended an extra 30 minutes in hot dog costume. You just want to stay in a hot dog costume, you dirty bitch.
I don't, but I've got to give people a reason to pay £250. And as I found out, torture is in fact a reason.
Yes.
So,
I want to find out what these bloody Halloween outfits are.
I think there's a Halloween event, isn't there?
Yeah.
Right. I am about to go live. So, okay. One moment, please.
One of them looks like a plague doctor. Yeah, while Grim is muted, I'm just going to say again how annoying it is that LJ has basically got pretty much
LJ
herself.
And Richard. Only Richard is streaming today, so if you want to head over to Bela Lugosi's shed, I'm sure he'd appreciate the viewings.
Good evening.
Hello.
And yeah, we were just discussing tomorrow's activities on my stream. So if you are going to be here, ACT! Oh, it's an odd quality because the mic is... I've been very ill-prepared today. Probably a keen-eyed person might notice smoke kind of rising from the bottom of the screen. That's not because I'm on fire. It's because I'm still smoking. Normally, I'd finish this before I start the stream. But I've crashed in. Yes. ACT, it's really good to see you. It's been quite some time. I hope you're well. Tomorrow... sponsored charity stream for Crisis, in which I will wear a variety of costumes while playing Beat Saber. Nothing can go wrong.
Unless, of course, you get one of your sabers caught up in your fishnet top and it pulls a nipple off.
That's precisely what's going to happen, Richard. It's basically what happened last time. So I now have nipple defenders. Because I did get a fairly persistent drop-in of people chatting things like TOS or show us your tits.
Yep.
See, I once got a nipple piercing caught in a fishnet shirt, and I'll tell you what, that's quite an experience.
Like, that's a goth rite of passage, really, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely.
Except that I never got the goth nipple piercing.
No, neither did Dad. Really not goth enough.
Precisely because someone did, and that happened, and I was... No,
yeah.
I wasn't really much of a fan of nipple piercings in the first place. So,
well, yeah, then
all fishnet tops.
Oh, I like a fishnet top. I like a good fishnet top.
I used to like that goth thing where, like, underneath your corset. Oh, I just realised that I need to put on an auto hotkey because this game is stupid and has WASD auto coded.
So we have a new friend.
I'm gonna have to do some faffing.
There's a little red folder in this here locker to tell you about the new friend. We got a little way here, but I kept from crashing out and I'm hosting, so wisely Rich has hosted the game this time.
Now I've got my fake WASD.
How do I put my flashlight on controller?
And I'm turning off the cheaty view.
Whistle works.
The whistling works. But the thing is that our friend
what
from
the Billio?
Yeah.
Oh man, you got it. It's that was the vagina thing.
As I was trying to say.
Well, that starts out fast, doesn't it? He doesn't mess about.
Well, this is not working with controller, lads. It's
I can tell you now that...
I think we might want to restart this level, Rich.
Yeah, because...
Yeah,
I have no idea what's happening. Yes. Let's restart and try being a little bit less rubbish, because, yeah, this went badly.
What I was trying to get to while we were nattering was, yes, our friend from the previous level has, in fact... found us and joined us there. So when we start testing our whistle button...
bad times.
Yeah, so the game's just crashed out again for me. So I'm going to make a... Before we go back in, I'm going to make a couple of adjustments. So I reckon it must be entirely my end. I think, LJ, you only crashed out when I crashed out. So if I... What I'm going to do is I'm going to not insist that...
Ready?
Use my... Can't spell today. I'm not going to insist that it use my entire screen estate.
Hey, invite.
Right, I have received your invite. Our Unity games. They're never done.
I think that there's a bit of a trade-off with Unity in how easy it is, relatively speaking, compared to a lot of engines, to get a workable game that you can move around in a short period of time. I've seen people in like 2-hour game jams create something approaching a first-person game in Unity. But the other trade-off is that you do have to put up with the fact that, that even in its completed state, it's going to be janky as all hell.
Is texture streaming good or bad? Do we know?
Is what?
Well, texture streaming good or bad?
I do not know what that is.
Neither do I, and that's unusual. FPS limit. So what I've done, I found out it was actually running in full screen, and that may well have been a problem. If I go outside the game, that probably causes it to have a fit. So I've made it into windowed mode, and I'm accepting your invite.
I'm trying to accept the invite.
You got the team all back together again.
Yeah, I had to do a tab there to first of all turn off the cheating view where I could see what Rich was up to. And secondly, because I've got someone to check that what happened last time on my charity streams where people in certain regions couldn't actually send me any money because there was no PayPal option for them.
Right. So, no whistling then.
I think it's a bad idea.
Awesome.
Right, there's a note there.
So I can't remember which button is whistle, which button is radio. Now I can't,
G
I can't test.
Okay, well, we don't need the radios, so you don't need either of those buttons.
No.
So you might want to go back, come back here, and just at the end of the corridor here, there's a locker with a folder in it.
Do we all need to read that, do we?
Well, we don't need to read it, but I think it's probably a good idea.
Entity 67. A humanoid being lies in the backrooms. It likes to trick people with party objects, but at the end, the entity will kill them and then it will collect their corpses, turning them into a bloody feast of human flesh and bones in order to convert them into cakes. It is said that if you see a party balloon floating... It was a time of balloons. It was a time of human flesh and bones.
This is not helping my phobia.
Starring Sandra Bullock.
Oh, I can hear a wet slappy dude.
Oh, fuck off, wet slappy dude. We don't want you here, slappy dude.
Oh, full of wet slappers.
I love how he just like casually shuffled up to us before and then just slapped us. Oh. Like...
I see a pumpkin.
Oh yeah, there's a one of them, yeah. That's like...
There's a locker here, but only one. No notice.
Yeah.
It was enabling all three of us to hide.
Oh, that fucking nearly made a shit myself.
Oh, there's a door here.
They are very fibrous.
Right. That's a door with a light at the end.
You, yeah, they do help you poop. It's a thing for constipated cats, give them canned pumpkin.
Really? I didn't know that.
Yeah,
right, we have a PC. Interact
with
PC.
Can you interact with
it? It seems that it works, but it needs a password.
Okay, there's a mysterious door down here.
Yeah.
No, not that one. Yeah, no, this is a different one.
I'm just having a quick mooch around here. Right. Oh, he's coming.
This way. Through the door.
Will that stop him?
This is a dead end.
I'm hoping.
Hey.
In case of electrophil, you add fuses to the fuse box. Oh, I've got some. I had some fuses, but I don't have them this time.
No.
Does anybody have any fuses?
No.
Check your inventory.
Isn't
appear that I do.
I
picked up a bunch from the last. Oh God.
Wait a minute. I do. I have fuses.
Nice.
Yeah. Because I think we get all the items from the previous level. Because we need to turn on the power for something.
Hey.
That's like the fuse box of my dad's house.
Brilliant. A load of bright lights to do absolutely nothing.
There's a thing that needed power later.
Because they're designed to look really bright, but not actually illuminate the environment at all. It's the kind of wonderful thing you can get up to with the lighting engines.
Yeah. So that's why we could go back to the next floor, because the...
Is that your bit rant for the day, Richard?
There's
the party room.
Oh, I can hear the...
I heard him squawking. Oh no. This Windows machine has been shut down to prevent damage to our computer.
There's a note next to the computer, the password. Have you seen all the computers in the zone? Some of them have useful information.
Do they?
Do they now?
Well, this one bloody well doesn't. Oh, stop the screaming! Let's not have screaming.
That's not on.
I've completely lost you guys.
Well, yeah, the party room.
Oh, I think I know where that is. I found
I see you. There you go.
So this door, this button on this door here, this will take us back to the first level.
Why would we want to do that?
We don't want to do that, but I'm just letting you know.
Well, if Fanny Face comes back, we might want to get really quick. Oh, here he comes. Whoa.
Oh,
hey, witch.
Oh, slappy mad. Oh, hang on.
I'm having a bad day. There we go. So you just you'll have to do all of that from context. Thank you, AC.
Oh, right, now I need to find the heartbeat again. Where's my heartbeat?
Streaming a blank screen.
Where's my heartbeat?
I'm in the party room with no cover and.
Right. Well, I can hear. Oh, do you know what? The scary singy voice doesn't appear to even be coming from him.
No, it's not.
Well, that's grand. Found a blue door. Right, I'm very beaty. There's exceptional beating going on, but...
EOS.
Oh, here it is. Here it is. No, it must be here. Must be here. Where's my heartbeat? Well... So it's somewhere behind that fuse box. Oh, come on. Yeah.
You can hear it very clearly.
I'm thudum thudum thudumming away like a trooper. A heartbeat. Nervous, yes. Very dreadfully nervous. I have been and am, but why would he say that I am mad? Bit of Poe there? Bit of Poe?
I'm insane with long periods of horrible sanity. Yeah.
Okay, I'm obviously missing the door.
Sometimes they're hard to find. Are you still in the party room, Grey?
Oh, no, I have left. Trust me to get stuck in the back rooms with a bunch of Poe quoting gothics.
Once upon a midnight dreary, while I pondered weak and weary over many quaint and curious volume of forgotten lore, while I nodded nearly napping,
I went down the dead end!
As of someone gently failing to find the fucking door.
I know that feeling. I'm behind the...
I cannot find the door.
Quoth the raven, GG nor re.
Where is this pissing door?
I found your body.
Is it like not a door? Is it like a computer that I need to
jump in?
No, type pseudo revive or something.
Crawl out a bit like Sadapple.
Still a door.
Okay.
I can see a shadow.
I've got 2 minutes 55 seconds to find the door
or
I'm boned.
In which case I think we try again.
I don't understand it. I'm doing loops around where it presumably is. Yeah, hello.
I think I need another person in the party room to complete this puzzle, I think.
Oh, this is frustration incarnate. I know that it's close.
Are you in the party room? You are not in the party room. My whole life is a lie.
Am I just walking past this and missing it?
I have found a computer with a C written on it.
C for computer?
And a computer with a red swiggle written on it instead of the blue, on the blue screen. And Mr. Vagina Eats Your Face is very nearby.
Oh, this is annoying. I found the area where the heartbeat is going mad. There's just no.
Maybe it's the other side of the wall.
Okay, I'm going.
Well, no, I can do a complete loop of corridors around the place where it's going off.
And another picture.
Shit!
That's not a good sign, is it? When someone scoops shit, things happen.
Yeah, I'm dead.
Smoothly. Well, I've got 58 seconds to find.
Yeah, I found it with like 7 seconds to go before.
Yeah, I'm having exactly the same thing. I'm trying
to find.
Oh,
I found it.
Oh, I found mine.
There it is.
Oh, I found it. We're all good.
No, it is We're possible all good. It wasn't bugged out.
I'm gonna grab all my things. Get my torch out.
Shit!
I need a locker. No! Nah!
Right.
Kicking off.
So we're all split up.
Your
panicked,
anxiety's kicking
and lost.
Off. I believe the game is doing quite well at what it aimed to.
It's certainly got the spooks out.
Ooh, the
this is certainly an effective Halloween experience. I have a red wiggle. I have a grey. Grey what's it?
I know. I was right where you were a minute ago.
I have a vagina-faced monster, presumably right outside the room.
Oh, no, it's currently stalking me.
I'm
so.
Sure I'll be protected by the
sigils.
I'll
take my locker somewhere. I can't see it. It hasn't walked past, I've heard it.
Lockers are a bit thin on the ground, aren't they?
Yeah.
Yeah. This is a...
Whoa, you son of a bitch. I'm getting inside the locker. I like the way that they patiently wait for you to get inside the locker. As soon as you hit ends the locker, it ends. But there's no way they can grab you during the animation, which is very different to how things go in Alien Isolation. Where if you're halfway in, the alien's like, I'm not stupid, Sunshine, get your ass out of there. Okay, we're
just,
back to.
There are 6 post-it notes on the screen as well of this PC.
Well, that's my own heartbeat again. Yeah, that's annoying.
Okay, we're back to Hiding in Locker Simulator 2022.
Well,
that's LJ's full game experience.
There's a
full game. I've done some running away.
There's a briefcase on the floor here.
Yeah, that'll be my briefcase. Nice. You might as well pick the bits up because I may not get to it sometime. I don't have a torch. I don't like that.
Oh, you probably need one of those.
What, so are you alive, but you haven't got your briefcase?
Yeah, there was a slight vagina face encounter. Right, I found a computer with a purple... Like, looks like the period key.
Right. My advice to you...
One with an eye.
Advice to you is, but the point where we came in... Where you've got the elevator and you've got the stack of lockers in front of you. You turn left there and just go as far left as you can go. Oh.
It's not me. It's not me, it's eating.
Oh.
Oh, no.
Lauren, are you getting it?
I got such a fright because he just appeared from around the corner. Did you dive in the locker, Gray?
I dived in the locker. I was really near you guys when that happened, but like the other, the walls have almost no sound deadening features.
It's my door. That's nice. He's probably going to be there when I go back.
Yeah, he likes to linger. No, he doesn't. Bye. You what? Fuck.
I'm a hider.
Where's my briefcase?
Oh my god, it's pitch dark in here.
Where is my brief... Oh, I would dive up here.
I am hiding.
Right, we need to do something about that now.
Oh, he's about to go past my door.
No.
There's no locker in here. How is this going to go? Why don't I have a peek out button? I want a peek out button.
There we go. There's no peek out button. There isn't in Alien Isolation either. And she exits the locker with about the same sort of explosive force. And
oh, yes. Drop kicks it open.
Yeah. Why would you do that? But that she does.
Oh, it's just crossed the doorway. Literally just crossed the doorway in front of me.
I feel this is going to need a bit of patience from us. This level. I don't think it's going to in any way be easy upon us. I'm trapped in a loop here, which has a blue door. But every time I try and exit this area, Mr. Slappy McVagina Face is...
Yeah.
It's right there waiting for me.
There's a switch here that says, press this.
Alright, so that's a party room.
Yeah. I'm intrigued by the press this. Should we?
There are two buttons that say press this. We need one of us on either side of the room.
Let's fun the guests. Fun the guests.
I'm trying to get there.
What does that mean?
Well,
the cake looks...
There's a certain sort of structure to the language in this that makes me feel that they're either copying the creepypasta or they are as bad at English as most of the creepypasta people are.
Yeah.
Right, so I'm here. You've got one button.
There's a button.
I've got
there,
another button.
There, yeah.
There's three buttons. There's one for each player. It needs all of us.
So,
I still haven't found my corpse, but
I can lead you to it as long as we don't get eaten on the way.
Can't promise anything.
No, neither can I. So LJ, where are you at this moment?
In a locker.
Yeah, I was gonna say, just check the lockers. You'll find her eventually.
I'm in like the first locker. Well, the one nearest the
end. There
we are. Yep, there we go.
Well, he's stomping about.
So you're in the locker right now?
Yes, he's just walked past.
Well, that's not a happy noise. Of all the noises that one can hear,
that has
a bad vibe.
You can't just say that.
We have buttons for you to push.
But he's down here at the moment, is what I mean.
We have buttons for you to push.
I'm just going to cheese it.
Right, then.
We need a willing victim. We need some support.
Cheesing it.
Right, follow. Right. Yeah. We're all together. Now we need to go back. We need to go over here.
He's down
there. Oh, there he is. Quick. In here. Get a button.
Get a button? I've got
a little fucking stamina. Right, here we go. I'm next to my button.
Three, two, one.
Let's play pop the wall or die.
By the way, why aren't you wearing your party hat, LJ?
Pop the wall or die?
I didn't know there was a party. How did I get a party hat?
Oh.
What do I?
Okay.
Ew.
Let's play pop the wall or die. Fuck. Right. Okay. Get popping.
I don't know what's happening.
Pop the balloons.
Oh my god.
Before the timer runs out, we die.
We're back to crystal maze. Start the fans, please.
What the fuck is happening?
The balloons hurt you.
Oh! I have a phobia of balloons in real life, and this is not helping it.
No, I can see that.
I think the designers of the game may well have had that in mind when they were making this. Clock's going. We're going to die. And what's more, it's figured out that you're the person that has the phobia of balloons. It's going to happen again. Go. I'll take this side of the room. Is the timer going quicker?
Yeah.
Ow.
Yeah, first aid kits, have you got them?
Let's play find your gift. Games are not always the same. There's no door.
And to play.
Oh. Let me just douse myself in almond water.
Oh.
Oh shit.
Wait.
Oh shit.
Oh, all left. No.
Is anybody else's torch behaving a bit oddly?
No. Mine's alright so far. What am I even supposed to be doing here? Like, what the hell?
I think we're supposed to be looking for a present.
Oh, stop sneezing.
But I don't know. I don't know what I'm looking for.
I'm following the left wall of the maze in an attempt to find the...
I'm just running around like a loom.
Oh no! Oh, guess who's in the maze with us now?
Who?
Is it Adele? Tell me it's Adele.
Is it Britney? It's Britney, bitch.
I found the gift. Oh, I found one of two gifts. This is piss take.
Well, now I am trapped in the maze and I'm dead.
Super good.
Well, I found one of two gifts.
Well, there's probably a gift each.
When I picked it up, it said one of two.
Oh, lordy! Oh, that was the party man. Oh, he's not nice. I don't like him very much.
Well, no.
Well, in the maze.
How's he, Garth? How you doing?
Oh.
Need to find the door.
Shit snacks.
I can hear the...
I'm stuck. Oh, I just got gold.
I think that's probably it for us. Now we're going to go around the maze and find our doors.
Yeah.
My heartbeat.
I found my door.
How when the monster's walking around, he just sees balloon. That's quite nice, isn't it?
Found the other gift.
I still need to find the door. I can't get it.
Not the easiest game, though.
He just got hit me again. So do we have to find two gifts each?
That door. No.
That might be difficult. Okay, my door was in the same place the second time. Helpful. Okay, a grab everything button would be nice.
Yeah, what wouldn't it? Hello. What are we doing now?
We're looking for a Prezi.
We're still looking for the presents. Oh, hell.
In this
fiddlesticks.
Janky ass laser quest place. Oh! Yeah. I am also dead.
No!
Oh, boy.
No, laser quest has much better visibility than this place.
Yeah.
But yeah, laser quest in like this would be brutal, wouldn't it?
What, was an actual monster, yeah, cheese.
Like fixing bayonets on the ends of it.
Just use real guns.
Yeah. Yeah. You always know you're about to have a bad time at Laser Quest when someone yells, fix bayonets.
See, I don't know where my door was last time, so...
This is a pretty effective maze.
It is, isn't it?
Okay. Let's play Find Your Gift. Just tell me where it is. Come on. We need another prizzy.
So every time we all die, I think it resets. And you have, like, a minute to find your gift.
Luckily, I can't even get my stuff because the monster's here.
Well, there's no lockers to hide in, so it's... Hi, Rich. I'm right behind you.
Alright. This monster's a prick.
I think it's right behind her!
Oh. I have found a gift.
I lost my bloody suitcase now.
I have found one gift. I'm back to one of two again. So.
Yep. Every time I think we die. Right, all three of us die.
Oh. Oh, for God's sake.
Oh, sugar, I've got...
This is it's a bit more treely, isn't it?
Yeah, so while the lights are red, until it resets, we have the chance to get gifts. So I think it... I think we all have to be dead at the same time, maybe? For it to reset.
I'd love to know where the gift is. Just a general inclination. Just a little idea.
Anything at all. I'd love to know anything at all.
I keep on finding complete dead ends.
Yep. I think that's the thing that happens. We just get... Not that it will help a massive amount, but... The door for me has always been in the now find your gift room.
It's not automatic death if it sees you, I think.
No, he has to get it.
I don't want to test this. I think he might be blind.
He doesn't seem to have eyes, does he? So.
Other gift.
No, I just...
I've got two gifts. The lights have gone, stopped being red. And another time has started.
Still around. Right, so I'm looking for my other gift.
I think that was two of two. I found another gift. One of three? One of three? You fuck. It actually roots you to the floor when he turns up.
Uh-huh. Yeah, good.
Oh, this is...
Keeping this heartbeat.
Are we going to get through this game? Well, Matry, you played DayZ with me. I call people you fuck an awful lot in that. I was often referring to myself, in fairness.
And to be fair, this guy is a fuck. And he just bit my face off.
Well, that's not very nice.
Calypso, how you doing,
Matry? I'm quite upset with that. That's my best face, that was.
Well, we've got to gifts one of three. We're now on a...
Are we reset again?
Five lives.
Are we reset again now?
Are they always in the same place? Right, one gift. One of three. So I think we have one set of gifts to find between us each time. And the first time we...
Oh, Gray, I've just looted your suitcase, sorry.
That's okay.
I'll give you stuff. What are we looking for? Another gift?
I just started running around looking for the gift. I forgot to pick my stuff up.
Well, you can have some of it back if you want.
It's okay. Let's just get this gift thing sorted. Gift! Two or three. Oh, is it not working today? Oh, sorry.
What not working?
My alerts for people coming in are not working.
Okay, it can only run after you for a short period of time, I think. Again, I'm wary to do any testing, but it just saw me. I froze on the spot. It started running towards me, and I just turned around and ran away. And it didn't follow me. There are definitely some rules here that I don't understand.
Something's missing here, I think.
You sprinted here. Oh my god, what the
hell? I don't think he likes you sprinting. I've worked that out by getting killed a lot. Don't think he's a fan of sprinting. Motherfucker hates cardio.
Alright, let's try that.
See, what the hell is that weird whistling noise?
That is just to creep you out. Don't panic.
I found one. That's three gifts.
Oh, good.
Three gifts.
Marvellous. Can we get out of this maze now? Can we get out of the hell maze?
I don't know.
No, the timer's started again.
Oh, so he turns invisible when the timer starts. Because that's his balloon there.
Need to find more presents, probably. Doesn't really tell you very much, this game.
I found one of four.
I've just nicked your suitcase, so we're even now.
Well, I've just found one of four.
So, increasing numbers of presents.
I've just found two of four. Fingers crossed.
No, this is LJ and Richard Calypso. Bella Lugosi's shed.
I just heard a bell.
I ran towards the light and it was your torch.
He died.
Yeah, he has a limited ability to chase you, I think.
Oh, well, he just freezes it. Oh, he looks so happy when he runs, though, doesn't he? Skipping along towards you. Like, hooray, I've got a friend. I'm going to turn you into cake.
Oh, I hope he does. I won't mind so much if I'm being turned into cake. I think I'd be kind of at peace with that.
It's becoming cake.
Yeah. Delicious cake.
He's gonna come right back to where I was, isn't he?
Geordie Goulet is alive. I am about to not be. Oh yeah. Son of a bitch.
Taking the moment while he's making horrible munching you noises to flee.
At least I died right next to my door. I think your door is the same place every time.
Freaking hell. It does look very funny the way he's skipping around the level, I will say that.
A sinister Mr. Blobby. A more sinister Mr. Blobby.
I was gonna say, Mr. Blobby's already pretty sinister. I was the only kid who wasn't scared of him at birthday parties. When I was little. Like, it was always one of the dads would dress up as Mr. Blobby.
Really? Blobby, is it? Ah! Get away from me, you freak!
Right,
Mr. Blobby song on LP. There you go.
Are we still on 3 or 4?
Well, I don't know anymore.
We don't know. You're the only one who's found gifts on this round, I think.
I just want the nightmare to end.
No!
These little tippy-tappy feet.
Yeah, I have escaped him. So you freeze for a second when he starts moving, but then you can run.
Oh! Clearly, I just gave up. Am I gonna never find this friggin' door? I do not know my way around here. Not good at directions.
He's really close by.
Yeah.
Wouldn't it be funny if you could only see you if you're wearing a party hat? We didn't know that and we've just put party hats on.
Well, I'm not wearing a party hat, so...
Anxiety meds time.
What's he found? Hello, Calypso. You join us as we are hiding in a scary maze from a colossal balloon-carrying monster that tears your face off.
Makes it into cake. Takes your skin and makes it into cake.
The skin dude is the other guy.
Is it? I thought this guy took skin as well.
He just chops you up and makes cake.
Oh, right, okay.
Oi, it's important to make these distinctions clear, you know?
Well, you can't assume.
I like to think they all get together and, like... Uh-huh. Mixed ingredients. Like one guy turns up with the flesh, one guy turns up with the meat cake.
Found a gift.
It's like a pot, like a potluck.
That was
like
3 or 4.
Like convention in Sandman.
I found your suitcase.
I can't find the door.
One more gift.
Found another. Found it.
Let this be the end of it. Hey.
That helped me find my door. What? Oh my god.
Is that the monster?
Can I lick my case?
What does it say now? Have we got another message? Let's play Blow the Candles. Oh, for fuck's sake.
For fuck's sake.
I am...
Yeah. Real tired of this shit.
Yep. Done with party games now. Thank you. Ooh.
Where's the candles?
My OBS has just gone super laggy.
Did anybody else see the monster's shadow? Oh god, he's...
He's hanging around. He's just dancing around with the balloon, invisibly. We've got to stand on the thing to play.
Okay, well, I'm trying to get this hat. I want the hat.
Well, if you go around the side of there...
Give me the hat.
And then point at literally 2 pixels.
Oh...
My OBS has suddenly gone super laggy, so someone can tell me if my stream's gone super laggy.
I will check for you.
Why can't I get the fucking hat? Give me the
hat! It's looking okay to me at the moment.
I want the party!
Well, as I'm panning left
if
and right...
If you stand exactly where I am...
Oh, there we go. Oh, sorry, there I was are. Trying to get it off his head, because I'm dumb. Right, okay. Do we have to... Excuse me, sir. Well, that was very kind of you to move, sir. I mean... Oh, shitting hell. Oh, well, okay, there's a candle.
There's something up with the floor.
There is indeed something up with the floor.
It's an invisible maze.
Oh,
it's the red tape.
Eh?
Red tape on the floor.
Red tape on the floor is the maze.
Literal red tape. Marvellous.
What a dick.
How the hell am I supposed to find my way
Well, you know when that timer stops?
Yeah, I know. Okay, so I can't... break.
I think the only way is past him. This has been set up so that...
Well, he's sleeping at the moment. That's all right. He's a sleepy lad.
Not for long.
Oh, you don't get constrained by the walls when the door's there. You don't need to go around the walls. I just found that out.
Right, so we've got to blow out. So we've got to go and blow out that balloon.
Candle
and that candle. Yes.
Yeah.
Don't get it wrong. He might offend him.
Right. I'm gonna blow out this candle. How do I blow out the candle? Oh yeah, blow out.
Oh shite, I'm right next to him.
Shitting biscuits.
Oh fuck's sake. I don't have my flashlight or anything.
Doesn't seem to have a problem with walls.
No.
Apparently he's skipping over at the ear, so he does.
How the flip are we supposed to do this then?
Not easily.
Quickly. Very quickly.
Yeah. If ever it's like three candles, then four candles, I'm tapping out.
Well, we need to get a shift on, guys.
I mean, I'm trying, but I can't see shit.
I think that's kind of the point.
Aha. Uh-huh.
Alright. I don't like this at all.
Oh, you don't need to be... You don't have to get to it, you just have to be within range.
Alright. That's worth knowing.
I was in range then, now I'm not. Oh, shit.
I'd have liked to have known that. About two lives ago.
Yeah. Well, now it's just... I've been trying to do that one for ages.
Quick.
I don't know where I'm going.
Guys, we're gonna die. We're gonna die.
Where the shit is the other candle? Oh.
Gonna have life issues at this point.
Well, GG.
Here's quite a few.
What did
it? Just singing like tiptoe through the tulips. No more lives.
Oh, we're on a restart anyway, but I'm gonna see what I can do here. You were just like staring at the floor and you just were like...
Well, I was trying to get my stuff. I'm a ghost now! There's a spooky ghost. I'm a spooky ghost. Oh.
Ah, fuck.
Yeah. There's nothing you can do at all there.
I think it's just a thing you need to do quickly. Two lives. No candles.
I'm dead.
That's why.
I'm dead, dead.
Yeah.
Like,
and
proper dead.
And the game closed.
That's because I'm dead, dead.
Oh.
And I forgot, and when it said spectate or exit, I hit exit. So I completely forgot about the whole me being the host thing. But it's probably a good time for me to have a quick 5-minute break to go and say goodnight to my daughter, refresh my drink, and have a wee.
Sounds good to me.
And learn how to deal with mazes. So until then, I'm going to be back in 5 minutes. See ya.
All right.
Yeah, I'm
going
to make some tea as well.
See you, sweet pea. Good night. Sleep well. I return. I'm not 100% sure whether I actually even remembered to put it on to back in 5 minutes or not. And whether I automatically undid that when I came back.
You did not mute your mic, but thankfully I secured the Be Right Back screen on my end.
Mm. Let me check. Yes. A funny feeling that my back in five. I must just automatically un back in five without realizing that I've done it. Never mind. It's all good.
I can't tell you because I was sat anywhere near the PC, so I'm just taking a little longer. My tea's just brewing.
Well, I'll start up. I'm back on stream now, so I'm going to start up another one. Get back into the lobby.
I've got to say that the growing rate of your facial hair rivals my own.
It's come back fast, hasn't it?
It feels like yesterday you were clean shaven.
Yeah, it's come back pretty fast. It's still got some space to go before it hits the glory of before, but I've definitely got my winter coat back in. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah.
Got the winter coat. Because it was just, there was one day during the summer when I'd got my full, great big bushy beard. And I was sitting there watching television with my wife. And I was just like this. Because my face was so hot, it was starting to itch. And as I was scratching it, I was getting sore patches inside my beard. And it was gross. So I'd have shaved it all off. And it was like, it was all red and irritated from where I'd been scratching for the last couple of days because of how hot it had been. So I just slathered my face with the moisturiser and went to bed. Woke up in the morning, lovely, smooth, baby soft face. Although I had to let my daughter do the first electric shave off bit. Because the last time that I shaved my whole beard off, I did it after she'd gone to bed. And when she came back upstairs, so when she woke up in the morning and saw it, she burst into tears because it was such a shock. So I was only allowed to do it on the proviso that I let Evie do the first buzz.
I think that was very wise. That makes it quite real, doesn't it?
Yeah, she did a very good job. I was impressed.
So, did I tell you the story of when I first went into treatment? And they were like, is there anything we can do to make you more comfortable? I said, could I go to a barber's, please? Because this is a bit of a mess. I think it was like the second day. They were like, oh, you're not really meant to leave like the house. We have to like clear some stuff and so on. And it's like, yeah, okay, I get it. But yeah, that would be the thing that would help.
Yeah.
So I did this. And so I got to meet people and so on. So one evening I was taken down to the Turkish barbers in the place I was living, which became my barbers from then on, because they were awesome. But when I walked in, I was like, can I have everything off? Like all of it. And they were like, top and beard. Yes. And yes, I'm aware we're live.
That was a terrifying change, that was. From like kind of long hair and beard to cue ball in the space of like an afternoon.
You know how I am with getting up in the mornings. So someone came to like knock on the door to go, they knock and then they come in. They're like, you have to get up now. You know, it's we get up at, I think it's 7:30 around here. The guy came in. He'd met me the previous day. And when I sat up in bed, he just went, he stared at me, turned around, walked away really rapidly, and apparently had a slight sort of moments down in the staff room. He's like, there's someone here and it's not Graham. Yeah. Someone in Graham's bed.
I'm always staggered by how much of a difference to my face shape getting rid of the beard does. It really just absolutely just alters the structure of my bones. It's crazy.
When they say it takes years off you, all it really does is make you look very, very different indeed.
Well, anyone's watched this before, well, obviously, I've seen a few weeks back when I was clean shaven, but if you haven't, I will find.
I was only just getting used to it, and now you've got a fairly substantial,
there we go.
You know, beard coming back in.
I
have finished my.
It's kind of tough to get both pictures work together, but there you go, that's me with. No beard. Beard.
Hand her back. We're discussing Richard's beard.
Yes. The important issues of the day, you know.
Someone put elf ears on you, which is fantastically awesome.
I put elf ears on me. I bought, Evie really wanted a pack to wear. I bought this set on Amazon. It was only like a fiver. And it came with a pair of really long ones, a pair of medium length ones, and a pair that are kind of quite more Vulcan than elf, and the biggest ones just absolutely huge on Evie, so I was like, oh, I'm gonna wear those. And yeah, if you put them on and then took them through the hair, long hair, it looks really good. Right, invite has been sent. Last piece of emergency chocolate. I do think that no disrespect whatsoever to the creators inside the back room. I think I've got one more 10 life attempt at this level in me. Just in terms of entertainment value.
Yeah, I think that there is. There's definitely a market for games that are just frustrating.
Mm.
People do seem to really enjoy those. Have we still got LJ? We just wait for her to get back. Well, I think we're waiting for her to get back.
I presume so, although she's not showing up as in game.
She's still on Discord, so.
Oh, I took a message.
I think she's probably just actually like making a proper tea and so on.
Very sensible.
Yep. Cool.
Highly professional. Here we are checking with... Twitter.
This what you should do with your dead air time. Absolutely. Check Twitter. That's what everyone else is doing.
You see, I think other people are a bad influence on me. When I do a solo stream, I'm just like constant voices singing da 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 da. But as soon as I've got a stream with other people, I'm sitting here just going, so yes, I knew I made a doctor's appointment for Friday.
Yeah. Well, for me, streaming and Twitch is socialization. I mean, that's what I use it for. So there we go. That's what I needed to do. It's not the compensation on my camera down.
Right. So I want to know what are these Halloween events then?
So that's what me and LJ were trying to sort of steam through because we want these Halloween event skins.
I want to do sewer because that looks like a plague doctor outfit, and I loves me a plague doctor outfit. Yeah.
I have returned.
Hello.
Yay!
And I tried the cats on some new treats, and they very much like them.
Excellent.
They're just called meat snacks.
Well, Aldi has got a big bag at the moment of catnip-infused Aldi fake dreamies. And ours are going absolutely nuts for those.
Well, as long as Schultz doesn't do, like, the thunderous poops with these new treats.
This is what I've never understood. Sorry, I interrupted you then. Sorry.
No, it's all right. No, just he's a sensitive boy. He can only eat certain flavours and brands of food, or he gets, like, the China Seas waltz very bad.
Yeah, I don't quite get. I've got several cats that are much the same. That if I change from, like, the Aldi yellow bag food to the Aldi blue bag food without doing at least 2 weeks of mixing them together, then two of our cats will get the absolute thundering shits. But either of them will come home with, like, half a dead pigeon they've happily been munching on without so much as a slight change in their gastrointestinal fortitude, and it makes absolutely no sense.
Yeah.
It's like, I've seen you drinking water out of a puddle in the back garden, just, and yet if I give you salmon instead of tuna, you shit your pants.
Yeah, that's what Schultz is like. When I first rescued him, he came with a box of Go-Kat and a note from the previous owner saying, please love him forever, which was very sweet.
Aww.
I was giving him the Go-Kat and he had the runs the entire first week. And I thought, well, he's probably just settling in, you know, it's been quite stressful for him. Ran out with the Go-Kat and just gave him some of the stuff I was feeding Django, which is James' well-beloved. And suddenly the diarrhea stopped and I was like, oh no, the first year and a half of his life, he's just had the runs non-stop because he was getting the wrong food.
Oh, bless him. So you can't rule out, though, with cats whether or not they've just vindictively created, forcibly sort of made them have diarrhea.
Mm. And Django's got the opposite problem, which is really fun trying to manage the pair of them. So I just have to alternate between wet and dry food.
Oh.
Seems to work.
Yeah, one of ours, Kofi, he does shits that I would be proud of. Just absolute Coke cans. Oh, that's bigger than you, mate.
Scary, isn't it?
So, excellent content as it is.
Yes.
I think Rich has declared that this is the last run at this maze for him.
Okay. Well, sorry.
Yeah.
Well, I was just saying that I just think that if we don't get through these office games in this next set of 10 lives, then I suggest we maybe go over to like something like Phasma. Just because I'm not entirely convinced how entertaining it is to watch somebody fail multiple times at a really repetitive task.
Elden Ring is one of the most popular games on
Twitch.
That's true. To
watch. That's a point.
She's bonkers.
Which is literally watching someone getting owned by a low-level skeleton repeatedly.
Well, I'm very aware of
people
how popular they are.
It's meant to be easier than Bloodborne, and I'm terrible at Bloodborne.
Well, so. I love the aesthetic of Bloodborne. I've tried playing it for like 4 hours and couldn't get past like the first corridor. So I've just come to the conclusion that anybody who plays Dark Souls, Borns, Sekiro, the Shadows Die Twice has just got something wrong with their head, if I'm honest.
Yeah, I am. Yeah, I haven't gotten past the first level of Bloodborne yet. I'm not very good at that sort of melee stuff.
Doing things the hardest possible way, repeatedly banging your head against the project in frustration, doesn't sound like anybody I know, Richard.
Well, there's just something about the Souls games. When you see these people who play all six of them without taking a hit.
Bloodborne, to be fair.
Oh, there's a video of a guy who plays Dark Souls 1, 2, 3, Sekiro Shadows Die Twice, Demon Souls, and Bloodborne.
Great.
All six of them, all the way through, and he plays them, and if he takes a hit of like a single pixel line of damage at any point, he starts again from the start of the first game. And I think it was like the sixth go or something, after like 27 hours of solidly doing it. He finally managed to play through all six games without taking a single point of damage, which I just think...
It sounds like a neurodivergent kind of scenario.
Do you think? Just, I was like, yeah, I mean, but it's certainly not my personal flavour of neurodivergent. But it's looking like I've got worms or something, but I've got a really itchy back. I'm going to use a sonic screwdriver to scratch my back.
I believe your wife was giving me advice on what to do with one of my cats licking his tummy too much.
Yes, I.
Yeah, I don't know if I'm going to get him in one of those suits. He's an outdoor cat as well, so I'm not going to let him out in it. But he'll be more amenable to it than the other one who would put me in hospital. So,
Add my wife on Facebook. She's lots of fun. She's another gobby northerner. Although from the other side.
Get on, yeah.
He's from Warrington.
Oh, yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. Well, his tummy doesn't look sore or anything, but it's just pink.
Okay. So. Right. I've got
to... He's asleep next to us.
Do that. Then that. How's that, Calypso?
What do you next?
Are we supposed to do anything before we go to the party room, or is the party room the whole level?
No, there's the computers as well.
Oh.
And we can't do the party room without the power, so we need to find that power room again.
Right. Well,
guys,
I think I've got all the fuses.
Huh? Yeah. Nice. We need to get Rich to the. That's it. That's the room.
I don't know where I found those fuses.
No, they're all the thing. That's it. Now everyone, crouch down and stop walking.
Why the crouch?
Because we think he's blind, so.
Oh.
I am not convinced of that anymore.
But he can. He does work on sound as well. So if you were to whistle, for instance.
Yeah. He's doing that again.
He might be legally blind. Or something.
Maybe he's just looking for his very focals.
No.
This is scary.
You've just gotten a knife out there. I was like, whoa, what? Didn't know it could do that.
That's a radio.
Yeah.
I hit the wrong button.
The light on it just looked like a knife. I was like, oh, we're going to shank the monsters now. This is a new thing.
They were hammer swords. You can also see whether or not he's radioactive.
Oh, well, honestly, I wouldn't be surprised if he was.
I'll spray him.
Both cats are having a good chew with themselves now.
Yeah, one of ours, Abby, she's got a fuzzy felt belly because she licked her entire belly. Not sore, but just hairless a while back.
Yeah, that's what Shuds did. Well, it started in the summer and I thought maybe he's too hot. And I don't know if it's just taking a while to grow back because I haven't seen him, like, at it. But I'm going to have to take him to the vet if it doesn't, like, sort of. But he doesn't, he's drinking and eating fine and stuff, so there's no other, like,
right, guys, support. I'm going to open the door and attempt to run for a locker.
Okay,
you've got a fire extinguisher, dude.
I was also going to try that. I have no idea if it will do anything.
It looks quite rude at the moment.
Hang on. Wait.
Yes.
Great.
That's
super
amazing.
He's going off. Wait there. He's in the next room along. There he is! Shit!
Standing very still. Drinking my almond water. I'm just throwing it straight on my face.
How are you drinking?
My delicious almond milk.
Did he hurt you? Because he was attacking me.
He had a little swipe at me, I think, because I definitely took a little bit of damage. Just a smidge.
Right, I see you guys. The party room is just past that red door.
Oh, no, this isn't the party room.
No, that's the way back to the first level. If you want to go there. That's really noisy, Richard.
It is, isn't it? Useful to know.
So
we know we can make a very loud noise if we want to.
I'm in the party room.
All right.
There we go. Hey. Everyone find a button. And get ready to pop some balloons.
Fuck my life. Okay, do we just press them at the same time?
2, 1, press! If they disappear, we've done it right. Let's play pop the balloons!
Right, I'm gonna start in the corner.
Pop them all or die.
I'm starting off in the other corner.
They haven't quite got the party aesthetic thing going, have they? Like... Oh! Oh! Oh god!
It's god, not like you weren't warned!
It's like being a 5-year-old at Blythe Sports Centre again.
I think we just have to do 3 rounds of this, and if you don't get them all, they hurt one of us. Yep. Oh, party hat. Don't forget your party hats. Gotta get in the spirit.
Oh, balloons!
Quick! I'm out of...
It's a while to get in range, doesn't it? The thing is, why do they always zone in on me? Can they smell my fear or some shit? Like,
yes. They can smell your fear.
Can I explain why I've got a fear of balloons? It makes sense when I describe it.
Is it a harrowing story?
People used to pop them.
Oh, well, that, but I also had glue ears, so it caused me a lot of pain when people pop
them. Ow!
Ow!
And that's it. Let's play.
The balloons were like, fuck
find
you,
find your
and
gift.
You're filled with trauma.
Right, party hat on. Yep, it's a creepy fun game, but this bit's very frustrating,
Here we go.
Where is my suitcase?
Well, none of us have died yet, at least, so we've got a few more lives to...
No, I did.
Oh, right, yes.
All right.
Right, so now we just have to go full on find the...
Right, so we start off by legging it.
Legging it. Left wall going.
What?
Oh, each time we find the presence, he will go back to sleep. And we have to find more presents on a shorter timer.
Why?
Got one!
Why? One of them. Oh! Well, I just saw the monster clipping out of the wall, so that was nice. I mean, that's what you... Oh!
There's it! Get it!
Wait, you... Ew!
There we go.
It's got offal in it!
Yeah.
Not very nice.
Just keep going.
Yeah.
Found one!
Oh, shite in hell.
Doing the following the left wall thing.
Oh, you're smart. I'm not smart. Yeah, I'm not a smart man.
Ah, shit.
But I know what love is. Right.
Love is like a box of chocolates. Oh, well, I tried to move in.
He scampers, doesn't he?
Filts is kicking his own tail. That's good, isn't it? Have you got your pink tummy? I'm gonna have to put
Yeah, he doesn't follow you very far, but you get frozen for a second.
I have to put a suit on here. You look like a little baby.
Oh, and then...
Oh, a little cat wetsuit. Amazing. Oh, I got properly jumped on then. That was the first time that I have been taken by surprise.
He's a very large cat. He's gonna need like a dog-sized suit. Aren't you? Is this a tummy trap, Schultzy? it's a tummy trap.
Oh, the old furry boxing glove.
Yeah, sometimes it isn't, sometimes it isn't. Sometimes he'll just grab you. Jango is a no-tummy zone.
I see Kofi is a grab my tummy and do what you will. He loves tummy rubs more than a Labrador.
Will you stop it? He's a pawn at the microphone. What are you doing?
I wish you could see the presents when you were dead.
Mm, I would be a bit of a pee though, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
That's why you can't see the monsters when you're dead, I think. Where was the party room? Because that's where the door tends to be, isn't it?
Rich, you're wearing your radiation suit. Is that in some forlorn hope of actually providing you protection?
No, it's because it's cool, and I like the feeling of rubber against my skin.
Oh, kinky. We don't kick shame, yeah, it's alright. I always wondered how some stuff on, though, like... This makes me think of that episode of Friends where Ross has got the leather pants. He gets stuck in them.
Well, you see, as a frequent purveyor of PVC and leather trousers in my youth, yeah, I can say that it's not uncommon for getting them off at the end of the night to be somewhat of a challenge.
Sometimes you bring someone home just so they can help you get the trousers off.
Yes.
No, I've seriously gone home with someone who was like, okay, yeah, I'm interested, but really, what I want you to do is just get this corset off.
I've got a lot of...
I'll help peel the leggings off, because...
I've got a lot of boots to unlace, and I want to be I want to be in bed before three.
Yeah.
Like, two out of three.
Why you get the lacy boots?
Two out of three ain't bad. But it is in this case, because we're still going to get eaten unless we get the other one.
I have this problem with Lolita dresses, like Japanese fashion. They're quite difficult to get on and off by yourself sometimes.
Yeah.
Especially if you're getting sweaty, because, you know, you're wearing loads of petticoats and stuff. It gets very warm.
Yeah. Oh, man.
I can't find this friggin' door for the life of me.
Oh, you mother... I've just got my stuff out of my briefcase, you shit!
Yeah, you do be like that, though.
I found two.
Oh, here's the noise.
Really? Right, go away. Oh. No, that was.
Oh.
That was somebody's ghost. That was someone else's ghost.
Me.
Oh, if you have not come across it already, Scroobius Pip a couple of nights ago did a live stream from the woods that has some serious, they did a live stream, spooky live stream from the woods, which has a serious bit of ghost watch.
What is that ace game?
I suggest I can say no more. Now I have to loot two separate briefcases.
Does that all get combined into one?
We started over.
I'm not happy about that.
If all three of us die, go.
There it is.
If all three of us die at once, it's back to the start. So we're two presents down to one now, I think.
What a bloody heartbeat. Come on. Where's my heartbeat?
Go when he's like a wall over from you.
No, hear him.
Come on. All I want to do is hear my ba-dum ba-dum ba-dum.
Is he gone now?
Where's my heartbeat?
We shall see. You're meowing. Ow. What are you doing?
Dum dum. Dum dum.
Oh, meow to the microphone. Go on. Go on. Do it. Meow.
Fighting the microphone.
He's meowing into it.
My favourite noise that one of my cats makes is Abby does the thing we call the argle bargle.
Argle bargle.
And it's when she's... Basically, it's when I'm deliberately annoying her. And she starts going... And it does sound for all the world like she's going... Argle bargle.
Yeah.
And, yeah, so...
Fucking grumpy now.
When Abigail's argle bargling, you know, there's about to be trouble. See?
Django just makes... The only time Django ever meows is when he's getting fed. This is a little angry one. The rest of the time, he just kind of makes demon noises, like...
Oh, I want him to meet Kofi, and they can just both sit there together and just go...
Django would probably run away. He pretends like he's proper hard, but he's not really.
Oh, Kofi's like a little snotty gremlin of a cat.
As if I wasn't cat broody enough.
He snores and snuffles all the time. He likes having his base of his tail patted, proper like kind of slapping patted, and he likes tummy rubs. So we've decided that he is he's in fact a Labrador that was accidentally born in the body of a cat. Oh. And yeah, because of his weird sinus thing, he's snorty. Right, I'm now dead.
What? Oh my god. 10 lives.
Unrecoverably dead because I couldn't find... There was no heartbeat. I was doing a quick lapse of the map. No heartbeats at all.
Alright. So...
Present.
Are we persisting? Are we trying again? Or are we fast running?
No, I'm a bit confused by that. Because literally... There was never... At no point walking the map did I ever hear my heartbeat at all.
It's really hard to find that.
Right.
Found one present.
Okay, he's now walking back towards the Let's Play Find Your Gift sign. Looping around back up towards the main party table.
You're the real MVP, Richard.
Oh, someone just ran past in front of me, right to left. I think it was you, Lauren. He's gone back down again. Back down again towards the... back down towards the Find Your Gift sign. And he's in that
section.
I cannot
find my door. I can hear the heartbeat, but I cannot find the door. I found your corpse.
Back in the Find Your Gift room. He appears to be able to walk through walls.
What?
I wouldn't be surprised.
Yeah, he's just 100% walk through a wall. Sneaky bastard. Coming towards you. Lauren?
Yeah, but I know I didn't get him in time.
That happened very close to me. Well, one thing we know is armor water's not much fucking use against this guy. Right, now that we were both dead, it started the timer again.
Yeah.
Oh boy. So this will be much, much easier with four people than it would be three.
Yeah.
One of three, we're on...
Still doesn't solve the problem with the map on the floor that he doesn't have to follow. What? It seems like...
Well, he does, when you're nearby, he seems to have to walk through walls. I think he can teleport for purposes of...
At one point, when the red tape was on the floor, he ran virtually the length of the room to kill you, and then just turned around on the spot and ran the length of the room to kill me. I don't think he's got any restriction in that situation.
Oh, for fuck's sake. That's good.
I've got absolutely no clue where that present is because I thought I'd done every inch of this map.
It tend to be like down the bottom of the dead ends from what I've seen.
Yeah, but I thought I'd been round every one.
It's always a narrow corridor or you've got to check behind you a lot.
But yeah.
So they're often like there's walls.
Oh, Grim, that's me. I'm near you now. Right.
You're not the only thing that's near me.
No, although he's not that far away. He's actually on the other side of the wall. Right. I'll tell you when he's going to become a problem.
He's about to become a problem for me, I think. Oh, I've got the sneezes. I don't know why.
I thought you died again.
Right, he's in the dark section off on the west side.
The dark section, eh?
Yeah, just off the Find Your Gift room on the west section of the map. So if you're facing Find Your Gift, off to the right, there's a couple of corridors that are completely black. And you need to go in there and chill out. Oh, that's me sneezing, man. Oh.
Fuck you, dude.
This is one of the situations where I kind of wondering if there is a trick that we don't know about. Like a couple of times when we were playing Labyrinth, and we would like be like, this guy just finally knows where we are, and then it's just like, ah, this monster cannot find you if you have something blue in your left pocket. And then we realised that we've been trying to.
It was never that obscure.
No.
I did notice that Labyrinthines had another update.
Yes. We may have to have another session on that. Which is weird, because Labyrinthine is basically this, the game, but not anywhere near as frustrating.
Well, it's very well designed.
What the frick are these presents, man?
I don't know, it's, yeah.
Well, I've ended up in here again, for fuck's sake.
I can see his balloon just like around.
Yeah, I saw that.
Maybe he's upset because we popped all his balloons, but we were told to.
Well, maybe that's it. Maybe he's like Lenny in Of Mice and Men and doesn't understand that he's killing me. I pet the rabbits too hard, George.
Are we all Curly's wife?
Oh, with his glove full of Vaseline. I had to study that book at A level. No, GCSE.
I did not, so I don't actually get any of the references.
Of Mice and Men by John Steinbeck.
Yeah.
Very sad.
There's an incredible adaptation with Gary Sinise and John Malkovich that in 2022 probably isn't actually that cool, because you've got John Malkovich acting like he has a developmental disability.
Oh, well, that's like My Left Foot, isn't it? With,
yeah.
Oh, what's his name?
Oh, that film does not sit well these days. I mean, it's clear. I mean, both of them are clearly an incredible piece of acting. But they don't sit well.
Yeah, they did the research and stuff, but...
Yeah, I think we're pretty stuffed.
We are, like, I can't even move out this corner.
I am going to do a rare bit of hitting Monsieur Google. And I'm going to go inside the back rooms.
Monsieur Google.
Office level.
Maze. I put maze on if you don't want like the whole thing. Shit. It's getting a bit teeth gritting now.
Yeah.
It's a bit, isn't it?
I've been eaten again.
Right.
I'm not.
Hooray.
I've got some bad news.
Yeah.
In the walkthrough for Inside the Backrooms office level, this is the walkthrough for Party Room. Press all the buttons on the wall simultaneously. Enter the red rectangle on the floor. Finish every round of the party games. That's the... So yeah, there is no trick. We're just shit.
Well, great. Some German practice on Duolingo.
It's a bird giving you grief.
Oh yeah, my wife is currently doing a competition with one of her colleagues.
Die Eule hat viele Angst.
I'm going around in circles. So, put it to the group. Do we want to try this again?
Kind of want to do some Phasmo, to be honest.
Are we getting a bit sick of this shit?
I think this is just locking ourselves into another hour of slowly trudging through a
grinding.
Yeah. Did anybody have a look at escape the back rooms for a potential other night?
I'm now on 3 of 3 presents.
Oh.
A glimmer of hope in the darkness.
Check out Grim here coming through on a 1v1 clutch.
What an absolute lad. What do we do now?
I do not understand the usage of the word clutch.
Wasn't that a band?
Full honesty, neither do I, but I think a clutch is basically an unexpected and impressive victory under difficult odds.
Peng.
Oh, found one.
Pog champ, Peng? Something like that. Yeah.
Poggers. It's poggers. Okay.
Yeah, which pog stands for player of games. I'm like, yes.
Apparently, Peng means very attractive.
Oh, the lordy. Oh, well. Okay. R.I.P. me. Yeah. I'm officially done with this now.
Peng is a very attractive person. If she a painting, then she's a very attractive lady.
Yes, I am aware of that one. But again,
see, I'm hip and I'm down with the kids.
Okay. 2 of 4.
My hand has clipped through the wall.
I think I was literally just running around in circles before.
Maybe we're overthinking it and they're on a really predictable path around the map.
Nope.
Well, you can't even find your way around the map though, because everything looks the same, so...
See, I honestly think I've learned a lot of it pretty well at this point, but it just hasn't helped me at all.
I found the last two that we were looking for right back at the start.
The problem is there's a central section. It's got like two straight lines of sight and one kind of diagonal one. They're all quite long and it seems like it's difficult to get around without travelling down one of these long thoroughfares, and he always seems to be on it the other end and just comes running at you.
It does not go down the little side turns or behind blind corners unless you drag him there.
Yeah.
So you can hide from him. Although now that I've told LJ that, you're just going to find a corner now.
Kind of did that before, to be honest. I'd already figured that out, so at least that he wasn't coming down where I was.
Yeah, he just stops. I just ran. Oh no!
Same afterwards.
Yeah.
GG.
I got two of the presents. If you can avoid dying,
that was an impressive. I just can't believe I couldn't find my. Nowhere in the map was I hearing a heartbeat.
I can hear a heartbeat, but I still can't find my fucking door.
I was either being really clueless or my door had bugged out.
Maybe.
That was really annoying because that was my first death as well.
It's reset. Why is it reset? We didn't find all the presents.
No, I think it's because you died at the same time as LJ was dead.
Oh, right, so the presents are in the same place.
I'm a spooky ghost.
I think this will probably do for us.
Right.
I'll be very surprised. And then we've got to blow out the candles, so...
The top end of the map now, stationary.
Yep. I can hear him.
Where is my door?
Top left, coming down the diagonal on the west east side. Assuming
I have no idea which direction I'm facing. So.
I'm assuming that if you're looking at Let's Play Find Your Gift, you're facing south. That was my.
That's good, because.
You're currently travelling south.
You're both dead, aren't you?
Yes. Like, yeah. As the door now. But it's coming down the diagonal corridor just past the dead room. About to come around the corner. Watch out.
I think we could probably call that done.
Yeah, I think so, because I'm not going to find this door. And here, the heartbeat.
There's just a little bit too much to do there without a checkpoint, I think.
Yeah. It could at least, like, when you get past this bit, like.
So, we could definitely do some phasmophobia.
Sounds very good to me.
Or.
I knew you were going there. So, how do you feel about Fall Guys, Richard? How do you feel about Fall Guys when it involves cute little xenomorphs?
What is Fall Guys?
Oh my God.
Fall Guys is a free-to-play thing on Epic, about 5 gig. It is a weird kind of... You're beans, and you're playing in things that are, like, large-scale, it's a knockout round. It's incredibly colourful.
Right,
And it's really bloody fun.
That's intriguing. I will have a look. But yeah, I think that this is... I think this is a finish on Inside the Backrooms. And I think that's probably, as it's finishing up with the spooky games for the evening, that's probably a good time to finish with the Bela Lugosi Shed stream. Mm-hmm. Bit of a short one, but obviously we are on NAF and Inside the Backrooms, and therefore that's what sort of curtailed things. I said absolutely no aspersions to the quality of Inside the Backrooms of the game. I'm sure there's a lot of people that that would be the absolute highlight of the entire game. But unfortunately, I'm a bit too rubbish at it, so I'm going to probably call it for the evening there. Thank you very much for LJ and Grim for joining me inside the backrooms. But until next time, which hopefully will be soon, I will see you. Take care and good night.